Imagine a day where we have an aquarium big enough with fish large enough in there that require me to feed them with something like this. Maybe someday. Until then, we'll use these. You know what this is, don't you? Yeah, you do. By hand fed, and since this guy is a highly venomous fish, this is about as close as we're gonna be getting. Hand feeding a wild caught lionfish within 3 weeks. I know that sounds a little bit bold, and to be honest with you, so many people when I initially put this video out told me it can't be done. You're not gonna be able to get the lionfish to eat anything but live. While they are a pretty interesting fish, they're a nightmare to keep in that aspect. Otherwise, they're pretty simple in terms of water quality parameters. They're pretty forgiving and a hardy fish. So I thought, okay, I'm not gonna be able to tame it, you know, like my little buddy Frank here, of course. But I'm up for the challenge. Plus, some might say it's not my first time keeping large predatory fish and large aquariums, and I figure if I can apply my freshwater tactics to saltwater, I'll be just fine. So there's a number of things I want to talk about in today's video, and I'm going to use this opportunity to do so. However, the most important aspect and interesting aspect is how I got this guy switched to being hand-fed. So knowing that this guy only accepts live foods and they're extremely difficult to wean off of live foods, I figured, man, I really don't want to have to feed this guy live shrimps and live fish for any extended period of time just to try to attempt to maybe get him off of those, because on this channel I don't want to promote feeding live fish to other fish, and we can argue all day about how natural it is as we sit in front of glass boxes, basically these fish's prisons. We can create as natural an environment as possible, but there's a lot of things in our control, including the diet. But clearly I've already made my stance being against live foods, and here's why. Most people are going to feed live feeder fish, like goldfish for example, which are very high in thiaminase. Thiaminase is an enzyme that breaks down thiamine. Thiamine is essentially vitamin B1. Vitamin B1 is responsible for breaking down and metabolizing proteins and fats. If we kind of circle back, if we just feed goldfish, the lionfish is going to decrease in the ability to break down the fats within that goldfish. He's just going to end up being big and fat and unhealthy and a shortened lifespan. But that would be too simple. Other deficiencies include him having problems with his nervous system or developing clamped fins. Him abruptly stop eating and accepting anything is another sign of thiamine deficiency. Heck, even I take vitamin B complex supplements because it's healthy to do so. So why take it away from your fish? The other problem is the fact that feeder fish are generally raised in deplorable conditions and raised up entirely too fast in order to get them to market to be offered extremely cheap and fed as feeder fish. Basically, these feeder fish end up being empty calories. Their nutritional value is extremely low. What is the true point of feeding them then? Not to mention, we're also introducing a fish that is handled so poorly that it has a high chances of internal or external parasites, pathogens being introduced, essentially just being a ticking time bomb in your aquarium. But I guess it's cool to watch them eat live foods. I've always wanted to say this on camera, but people that get off on feeding other animals, live animals, are truly, in my opinion, trying to compensate for something else. You guys figure it out. Sorry for being a jerk like that, but it's just the way I feel. Plus, it's my channel, so I'll do what I want. All right, so we now know why I don't want to feed live foods and why you shouldn't. Of course, there are other alternatives to live foods. You could potentially feed different types of mollies and other guppies and other cheap and easy to breed live bearing fish, even some shrimps and different things like that. But in my opinion, again, that's an awful lot of work for something you're not truly controlling with the fish's diet inside the aquarium. With prepared foods, we can ensure that we're giving them everything they need, and if they need something else, we can simply add it. So for this guy, I want to make sure you get what you need. So my attempts were as follows. I should probably mention that about 2 years ago, I made a video on how to wean large predatory fish off of feeder foods, or tricking them into eating frozen or prepared. Essentially, my large Asian arowana didn't want to eat prepared foods anymore. He wanted live. Too bad for him, I'm not doing it. So I figured maybe I can mimic live foods by taking a sewing string, tying a piece of shrimp to it, or whatever other foods that they used to eat, cutting it into the shape of a fish, loosely tying it to that string, and drawing it through the water, kind of jigging it and pulling it a little bit to simulate a fish struggling in the water or trying to get away. 99% of the time, they go for it the first time. This guy wasn't having it. I don't know if I didn't starve him long enough because I only waited about a week before I offered that method. But he just wasn't interested. Of course, the snowflake eel certainly was, and I'm going to say that when you have a fish in an aquarium that doesn't eat, but there's other fish in the aquarium that will eat and readily eat, a lot of the times this will entice the other fish to know, okay, this is food, I can eat that. So I'm gonna have to credit the snowflake eel at least somewhat. The benefit to trying it and attempting this with this lionfish though is that he was showing interest. Interest is everything to me. You know that this is food, you know that it smells or at least tastes good, and potentially you're going to eat it one day. With that, I dropped the string method because I'm not going to be able to mimic that for every feeding. I've got too many aquariums to take care of, and giving them one-on-one attention, if this was like my only aquarium or if I only had two or three of them, it would be a lot easier, but I need to be able to drop food in and keep taking care of everything. For example, as we film this video, I'm over here doing a water change on the rainbow fish tank, always working. I read a comment one time that said, Joey has people helping him do this. I film alone, I edit alone, I take care of everything alone, I build alone, etc. Everything you see is a creative process from me. I decided I'd switch this guy to the thongs or tongs. He showed the exact same interest in this type of feeding as he did the string, except now I can control it a little bit more, and by wiggling it around in his face, he seemed to be interested. But he still wouldn't go for it. But again, I have the advantage of him being interested in this food. I couldn't figure out why he wouldn't take it though. I decided maybe it's the color of the food, maybe it's the shape, or something along those lines. I decided for this time and this time only, just to make sure he's actually eating and he's not sick, I'm not going to jump to medications and try to treat a fish that doesn't need to be medicated and inappropriately stress him out unnecessarily. I'm going to feed him a live fish. I'm not going to feed a goldfish. I'm going to feed a fish that, if he doesn't eat it, can still withstand salt water coming from fresh water. So I bought a few inexpensive mollies which can survive in salt water. I decided if he doesn't take them right away, I'll remove them. I took the molly by the back end and offered it to the fish. And I want to use some viewer discretion here. This is the first and the last time you'll ever see me feeding live food, but it is for educational purposes as to, you know, getting this fish to stop doing that and stop eating these. And I think it's important that we see this. I held the molly by the back of the back tail and offered it just like this, just holding it in the water. As soon as he came at it, I let it go and he ate it right away. This did two things for me. One, it lets me know that he's willing to eat, he's going to aggressively feed, and there's nothing wrong with him. It also kickstarted his metabolism and got him eating again, because at this point, after a week or two of not eating, I felt maybe he's emaciated, where his stomach has shrunk so much he just can't eat. So this was gonna stretch it back out again, get his metabolism pumping, and next time I offer him food, he might go for it. And now I want to say it's almost a problem, but every time I feed this aquarium, as soon as fish or food of any sort touches the water, the snowflake eel comes out wanting it. So I have to feed him first. And in doing so, it gets the lionfish all worked up. He can smell it in the water, he can taste it, he's looking around, he's following me. So I started to offer him foods with the tongs. And I noticed right away that he would go for them, but not as aggressively as he would go for the live fish. I can't have that. I don't want him to just kind of, you know, allow it to fall in his mouth sort of thing. This is what he does. He floats all over the place. Earlier he was upside down. So instead of releasing it right away, I kind of hold on to it and make sure that he's biting it off. Now these guys will engulf it. They extend their jaws, causing a suction of water to go in through their mouths, and that's how they suck the fish in. but he wasn't really doing that at first. He was just kind of opening his mouth and biting at it, mouthing it. So I wasn't letting it go right away. I'd wiggle it, pull it away pretty quickly. Eventually, he went for it. And now every time I offer to feed him, he will eat from these tongs. Within a 3-week period, we got a wild caught fish only eating live foods to hand feeding. Other things I've done to this aquarium though is I recently built a new sump for it. We'll do a video on that in the near future. Anyways, I hope you guys enjoyed today's video. If you're not subscribed to this channel yet, and this is the type of videos you like, then make sure you subscribe so you don't miss any of them.